Before we take a look at what's next quarterback-wise for the Houston Texans, Pena has a thought. Pena calling in. What's going on?
Hey, Paul. So Friday, before y'all got off the air, you said that the Texans weren't going to have a quarterback for the next 3 to 4 years. And I've been saying this for about a year now. That within those 3 to 4 years, that aligns perfectly with someone that is a five-star commit to Texas. He's going to be graduating from the university within that time.
Jeez, we're getting desperate.
That's Arch Manning.
We're getting desperate.
Does that sound good to you?
Pena, appreciate the phone call. We're getting so desperate.
That's a great call. I love that.
Calm down, Sean Mapes, UT fan behind the glass. Let's relax.
Champ
a
of the day,
bit.
Pena.
Let's see the guy like play in college.
Play higher than like 3A in Louisiana.
I just this franchise has just had bad luck. Look, I am done. I am done with Davis Mills. I'm done. Okay. It's time to move on. This is something I used to do back at Knights on the Flagship when I was also not endorsing the quarterbacks and no one listened, even though I was kind of mean. I'm kind of happy that no one listened, you know, in management. Felt like I could have gotten in trouble. But, guys, it's done. I got hungry eyes, baby. Oh, yeah. What a song. So what do you do when you get back into that single world? Maybe you're someone who's been married for a really long time. Maybe you're a commitment phobe like myself that never wants to settle, even though when he looks in the mirror, perhaps he's the one that someone would be settling for. First off, when you are single, you block your ex. I think Russell Wilson deserves a block after what we saw in this Subway ad that he posted to TikTok.
Hey, you want to split this Subway sandwich? It is my signature sandwich. It's called the Danger Witch. And it's dangerously good. Be careful, though. It's spicy. You ever done anything dangerous?
Loudy. Mm.
Jeez. That is dangerous. I've done something like that, too. I won't tell anybody. Listen, one time... never mind. That's too dangerous.
I'm not going to lie, I did laugh at that. Sometimes when he is just being straight corny, he can be funny. When he is talking after a game and talking about how this is championship football that we just played on Sunday Night Football against the San Francisco 49ers in a game that they won 11-10. That's where it gets a little bit hard for me. But you block your ex when you first get back into the dating pool, okay? Because Davis Mills is a three-nighter. Maybe. Two-nighter. Maybe a one-nighter. We know what's happening here. It's not getting any better. Up next, what am I doing? You check the Instagram profiles of, I don't know, people that you may have been interested in the past. Yeah, they were single, but do you see any pictures of them with their significant other? If you don't, slide away. At least if you're dog like myself, or Ime Udoka. We'll get to him at 10:45. I am checking the Instagram profiles of Gardner Minshew. Hey, Jalen Hurts, MVP candidate. Gardner looks hot in those jorts. Ooh, thirst trap. Taylor Heinicke. How about a return tribute video to Taylor Heinicke? He was a Texan once. Colt McCoy, one of the greatest winners ever in UT history. I know Sean Mapes would sign up for Colt McCoy.
College football history.
Yeah. Case Keenum? Huh?
I know Jeremy Branham's going to sign up for that.
I wouldn't be opposed to taking a flyer on some of these guys at the trade deadline. Say you feel like spinning a fourth round pick. There's a certain point where you're going to get to where you're going to think to yourself, damn, like, what are we really getting by putting Davis Mills out here Sunday after Sunday? How about another option at quarterback? How about Cooper Rush? This is a serious question. Would you consider trading a mid-round draft pick once Dak Prescott's back to the Dallas Cowboys, assuming they accept it, to have Cooper Rush for the rest of the year? Sean Mapes? Huh?
No, because, like, kind of what's the point? But I do...
There's some upside there. I don't know.
Not enough upside.
Listen.
He's a nice guy. He's a really nice guy. You would love him, Paul, but he's not my type.
Oh, wow. See, that's the perfect way to talk to somebody who's trying to set you up with a friend that you don't find attractive.
He seems nice, though.
I have used that line a couple of times. He seems so nice. Well, I don't know. Here's Jerry Jones talking about Cooper Rush just the other day.
There's no question. He understands this offense. He has got the makeup for a top quarterback, and I underline the word makeup for a top quarterback. And we're very fortunate. The purpose of the backup quarterback in the NFL is to be able to step in and have your team function on all the cylinders without having to give up some of your offense that the starter usually takes with him when he leaves.
Come on. I mean, that's a pretty good endorsement. He's got the makeup of a top quarterback. Just like makeup is important on Instagram, you know, you see a lot of people wearing it, you see people without it. Might not be sliding in the DMs so quickly. Just a thought. Cooper Rush, trade deadline, huh? But here's what I'm really looking at. I looked at a couple of quarterback draft prospect profiles on ESPN.com. Todd McShay put it out. Here are the guys per Todd McShay who are the top quarterback prospects. This is a couple of days old. He has C.J. Stroud of Ohio State as the third best prospect in this year's draft. I'm swiping left on C.J. Stroud immediately. Sorry, I don't do Ohio State. Does that make me racist? Maybe. Don't care. You got to have, you know, standards, but you also have a type.
Yeah, everyone has deal breakers that can be as flimsy as they, you know, as what school you went to.
Mm-hmm, exactly. And, you know, like Ohio State, for some, like maybe that's thick with a couple of C's for someone. No, I'm into people that possibly have body issues and maybe you're a little anorexic or obsessed with working out. You know, that's what I'm into. But you might be into somebody else. How about a Bryce Young? Fast processor. Quick release per McShay's draft profile. Maneuvers in the pocket. Oh, kind of know how to maneuver. Very good ball placement. Oh, tell me more. Touch on the perimeter. Oh, knows how to lead receivers. No moment is too big for him. He is a little short. Some people, you know, like a shorter person. There's a term for that.
Let's wait and see what's on his profile, all right?
Okay. He's the fourth overall profile, Bryce
Young. Definitely going to be 6 foot on his dating app profile.
Yeah. Oh, definitely.
At least.
Definitely. I wonder what Alabama will list him at their pro day. Do you think he'll be like 6'1", 6'2"?
Yeah, he'll be the most, whatever it is, the most fraudulent ever. Unless he's 5'10". Unless he clocks in at 5'10".
I might be pronouncing this guy's name wrong. Don't care. He plays for Kentucky, and I'm mad that the Kentucky Wildcats are better than the Florida Gators. 21st overall prospect on McShay's list, Will Levis from Kentucky. Ooh. Quick-paced, quick-hitting offense. Relatively quick release, strong arm. Jumps off his hand, the ball does, with velocity. Ow. While he hangs on in the pocket, he knows when to tuck the ball and run. Huh. I'm intrigued. Hadn't heard of this guy. And one last one. Tyler Van Dyke is the last quarterback on McShay's list. He got benched. Miami is a disaster. And tell me this doesn't tell... This does not sound like Davis Mills. Van Dyke misses within the strike zone too often over the middle and is inconsistent throwing outside the hashes. His touch and timing on downfield passes needs to get better, and I'd like to see him speed up his decision-making. That is Davis Mills. So Tyler Van Dyke, we're swiping left on him too. So there you go. That's the first episode of Texans Quarterback Hungry Eyes.